Jy is ingeskakel op U Extra, ons gaan voort met perspektief. Nou die afgelope week het geweld in huishoudings weer onder ons aandag gekom na 'n video wat die sangeres Bongikile Semelani op sosiale media geplaas het waarin haar lewensmaat Mantla Mampumulo haar aanrand. Action Breaks Silence is 'n organisasie wat hom beywer teen geslagsgebaseerde geweld. En Gatlisho Manenje is die programbestuurder van Action Break Silence South Africa. Sy is hier by ons in die ateljee. Gatlisho, it's very nice having you here. Thanks for coming in. First of all, please explain to us exactly what it is that you do at Action Break Silence to help, because you focus on younger children.
Yes. Okay, thank you so much for having me. So Action Break Silence, first of all, is a charity organization that aims to eradicate the gender-based violence. So we want to have a world where women don't fear to exist. So at Action Break Silence, I'm the country manager, as you already said. We run in 4 different countries, South Africa, UK, India and Kosovo, and I'm the South African manager.
But you're only doing it here in Gauteng. The programs are only here in Gauteng. Hey?
So we're currently running in Gauteng. We have projects running in Soweto and in Atteridgeville. And we also give lessons to other provinces and other organizations that are interested in teaching our program outside Gauteng.
So please tell us about your programs. What is it that exactly that you do?
So this is an educational program where we teach young girls and boys in primary schools. We go into the schools, so we teach for 12 weeks, so we get an hour a week at each school. We teach young boys a program called a Hero Empathy Program, and we also teach young girls a program that we teach them self-defense, and this gives them empowerment.
So you actually teach the girls how to defend themselves physically against somebody attacking them, and the boys empathy.
Yes.
How to love, how to take care.
Yes. So just to explain more on that, for the young girls, we teach them the skills on how to defend themselves. Mm-hmm. But the main idea there is for them to be comfortable in their own bodies. Because, you know, as women, we are taught that you, with a certain body, you cannot do this or you can do that. We shy away from our own bodies. So we want to give the women empowerment so that they can have power in their own physicality, so that they can understand their own bodies. But we package that together with self-love. And that makes them to be assertive, to know that I don't want to be touched this way. I don't want to be, you know, violated. As you can imagine, rape happens on the streets, but sometimes it happens inside the home, and that is not going to be a very forceful kind of rape. So that's the way we want the children to understand that if this is not feeling right, even if it's my uncle or my dad, it's not right. Mm-hmm. So that's why we're saying that we're giving them empowerment through self-defense.
Yeah. And the boys?
So the boys, we're teaching them the Hero Empathy Program. This is a program where we first teach the boys how to leave the stereotypes that they learn from a young age, that men must be like this, boys must be like this, and these things women cannot do, that thing men cannot do. Men cannot cry or women cannot be this. So we are teaching them to leave those stereotypes. We're helping them to unlearn the stereotypes that everybody is equal. They must be empathetic. They must understand women. They must also understand themselves as men. So that's what we're doing with the young boys from a very young age.
And how do they like it? I mean, do they understand what you're trying to convey to them?
So as you can imagine, we have to teach it on their level. So when we go to the schools, we have pictures of women being assaulted, men assaulting women, and then we first show them the pictures and then we ask them how do they feel about the pictures. Most of the boys will laugh and say that, yeah, she's a woman, she's weak, and then the man is feeling strong. And then we then now go back to the same boys. We ask them, how would you feel if this was your mom, if this was your sister? And then they sit back and really think about it. That I wouldn't like this if this was my mother, I wouldn't like this if this was my sister, or if this was my friend. So that's how we try to make them see that this pattern that they have seen as normal. Because when you first show them the pictures, you can see that for them this is normal. For them this is funny. For them this is okay. But now when you start to ask the question, then they start to think about it further. So that's how we do it for the children.
And it's important to include the boys, to teach them too.
Yes.
And what is the reason for that?
So I always say you cannot give what you don't have. Mm. We've always put the girls and the women first. They always say bring a girl child to work. We always have this fancy women empowerment that dinners and everything that are going on. But where is the man in this? We're always bringing out the princess and the queen, building the princess and the queen, but for who are we building this for? So we are not feeding the men and the boys with the right, the right food like we are feeding the women. Mm-hmm. So that's where we come in, and that's why we do it amongst young children, because we want them to learn the empathy when they are still small. We want them to know that they have to be empathetic to the other person. It can be to their brother, it can be to another man, it can be to a woman, but they need to learn empathy. They need to learn respect. They need to learn that the other person also deserves as much respect as they do. That's why we teach them self-love, so that they know that they love themselves enough, but they also love the next person and respect the next person similarly.
And how do they receive it? How do they respond, the kids? What do you see?
So what we see is that in the schools that we teach, we always go back at the end of the 6 weeks, because we first start with the 6 weeks. So before we run the program, we have some questionnaires that we ask, and then post the program, we also go back with the same questions to see how has things changed. So that's one thing that we do to measure. But secondly, we go back to the teachers, we go back to the parents to ask how the program has impacted on the kids, and we get a lot of positive feedback where the teachers are telling us, this child was a bully, but since you started the program, things have changed. The principals, they are coming to us with letters, they're sending us letters of thanking us that since we started to run in their schools, the bullying, the complaints from the girls, things are better in the schools. Yeah. Yeah,
that's great. Eh?
So yeah.
So and then the important thing is also to break the silence, because I think that's quite an important thing, hey? Because the thing is, when you see your neighbors or when you hear your neighbors fighting, I mean, you're not going to interfere, you're going to keep quiet.
Yeah.
So what is your message to people and also to viewers and maybe people who are in this situation, males and females, because I think both are victims, not only the woman.
Yeah.
What is your message to people?
So, as our name says, action breaks silence. So we are about breaking the silence. We are about breaking the stigma, because you can imagine that sexual harassment it has a lot of stigma attached to it. So if my husband goes beating me up at night, I'm gonna put makeup on tomorrow and pretend that everything is okay, because I don't want people to stigmatize my relationship. I don't want people to see me in a certain way that I don't appreciate. So we as a society have made a nest for it to exist. So what we are coming with is that break the silence, come out, talk, get help, get support. So we are not only saying to the victim or to the survivor that break the silence, but we're also saying to me, who's not experiencing the violence, to say that it's not for you to laugh at someone, it's not for you to enjoy somebody's pain, it's for you to support, it's for you to exist in giving them the support and showing them the places where they can go to for help in order to break the silence. I mean, imagine the 13-year-old girl that was raped recently. I'm sure you've seen that in the news. She was raped by classmates, three boys, and somebody was taking a video. Just imagine whole. So these boys, they don't have empathy. They rape this young girl. Somebody's taking a video. Where is the empathy in
that? Exactly.
You know, that's why I'm saying that we build a nest where this exists. And I think social media is also fueling that, because after a certain incident, then you start to see that everywhere is, you know, it sparks the vibe.
Yeah.
It starts to happen, you see. So that's what we're also trying to teach and make exist, that we must also get the vibe of saying that we need to eradicate this thing.
Thank you so much for coming in. It was lovely chatting to you. En dit was Gatlisho Manenje van Action Break Silence. En 'n webadres indien jy dalk meer inligting soek, is, laat ons gou-gou kyk wat die webadres is. Dit is www.actionbreakssilence. Dit is ook op ons skerm. Baie dankie dat jy vanaand saam gekyk het. Nuusdag Perspektief is môre aand terug met nog nuus en stories en onderhoude van die dag. Totsiens.